Hello friends, welcome to Dr. Rajkumar's Learning Lab. As the biggest democracy in the world, elections play an important role in India, which elects the representatives for the parliament, which elects the people's representative to the parliament. So, since independence, there are many reforms have been brought by the government in the election system of the country. Recently, government has come up with a major amendment to the election laws which can reform the election procedure in the country. So we will look towards the election reforms which government is trying to bring. So what was the context? So election laws amendment bill 2021 has been passed by the parliament. So this bill amends Representation of People's Act 1950 and Representation of People's Act 1951 to implement certain electoral reforms. So here, Representation of People's Act of 1950 provides for allocation of the seats in the parliament as well as state legislature. It provides the provision for the delimitation of constituencies for elections. What are the qualifications of the voters? How the electoral rolls have to be prepared. Coming to Representation of People's Act of 1951, it has the provisions regarding to the conduction of elections to the parliament as well as state legislative assemblies, the offences related to the elections and the disputes related to the elections to the parliament as well as state legislature. So, certain provisions of these acts are to be amended by the recent amendment bill. So what are the different reforms this bill tries to bring? The first reform is linking of the Aadhar with the voter's ID. The government wants the Aadhar of the persons to be linked to the voter ID. But this linkage is not mandatory. So what was the need for linking of the Aadhar with the electoral roll? Even though Aadhar is not a proof of citizenship of India, it is only a proof of the resident of India. But according to the government, the linkage is necessary to fight the fake votes in India. There are numerous fake votes or duplicate votes in India. A single person, he votes multiple times in a single election. He votes multiple times at different polling stations on the name of different persons. Secondly, multiple enrollment has to be stopped or the avoided. What does mean by multiple enrollment? Multiple enrollment means a person is enrolled more than twice or once at a different places. For example, a person is a resident of Delhi, he is registered as a voter in Delhi. But after a certain period of time, when he migrates to another city, for example Mumbai, he again registers himself in Mumbai as a voter. So the same person is eligible to vote at two different places. So to avoid this, the government wants to link Aadhar with voter ID. Thirdly, to purify electoral roll, this reform is very much necessary. So there are instances where a single person's name has been enrolled more than once. So to remove this multiple enrollment or the purify these electoral rolls, this linkage is necessary. But many of them has raised concern about linking of Aadhar to voter ID. So why? According to some experts, this move is outside the parliament's legislative competence. It means that parliament is not empowered to make such laws which can link Aadhar with the voter ID. Secondly, it violates the fundamental rights of the people. According to recent judgment of the Supreme Court under Puttuswamy case, right to privacy is a fundamental right under Article 19. So it violates the fundamental rights of the people. If Aadhar is linked to voter ID, it can transfer the personal information to the government. So here, the right of the privacy can be breached. Thirdly, there can be voter profiling. What does it mean? By linking of the Aadhar to voter ID, the government can have access to the personal information like caste and religion. This can be used by different political parties for targeted campaigning during the elections. So this was one of the third concern of this provision. Now there is also a fear regarding mass disenfranchisement. Now what does it mean? That if the linking of the Aadhaar to voter ID is done, lot of people will be denied right to vote. Even though it's not a compulsion to link the Aadhaar with voter ID, many of them will be left out from the electoral rolls. Now such incident took place in 2018 during Telangana and Andhra Pradesh assembly elections. More than 50 lakh voters were left out of the electoral rolls. Also, the Supreme Court has said that through the constitutional bench that Aadhaar is not mandatory for many of the schemes like linking of the Aadhaar with mobile or linking of the Aadhaar with bank accounts. Aadhaar is only necessary to get the subsidies or the welfare schemes. So it goes against the judgment of the Supreme Court as well. So these were the concerns raised for linking of the Aadhaar to voter ID. There are certain other reforms as well which the bill brings. First is qualifying date for enrollment in electoral roll. Previous act allowed a person to enroll in the electoral roll only once a year. That means a person was eligible to register himself before 1st of January each year. But if a person is eligible to vote after 1st of the January, he has to wait for 1 year to get enrolled in the electoral roll. But this new law brings in four different registration dates through which a person can be registered himself under the electoral roll. A person can register on 1st of January, 1st of April, July 1st and October 1. So there are four different stages during which a person can register himself in a year. Now the bill also enhanced the powers of the state governments. The previous act permitted state governments to requisite premises which were needed for the storing of the ballot boxes. But now this bill gives the power to the states to requisite the premises for the counting of the votes or storing of the voting machines, as well as to store the different polling materials. So the state government can also requisite the premises for providing accommodation to the security forces as well as polling officers. So this act has enhanced the powers of the state government. Lastly, this bill tries to bring gender neutrality with respect to service voters. Now, who is a service voter? This provision was applicable to the persons who were serving in the armed forces. So the wives of the persons who are serving in the armed forces, they can register themselves as a service voter. So through the proxy, these persons can vote in the general elections. But the husbands of the women who were serving in the armed forces were not allowed to register as a service voter.
So this bill replaces the word wife with spouse. It means that husbands of the women who are serving in the armed forces can register themselves as the service voter. So the bill brings here the gender neutrality with respect to service voters.
So these were certain reforms which this bill tries to bring with respect to elections in India. But there are certain concerns of the bill which has to be addressed. Thank you for joining us. Thank you.